What's up, Galactic Survivors? This is KJ4E, and welcome back to my No Man's Sky Let's Play. This is episode 7, and we are just sitting here on... What planet are we on? We are on the Ronald Futcher planet. Futcher. Sorry, I'm not sure to say your last name, Ronald. I went ahead and named the planet after Ronald. He was next on my list. I actually named the system after myself, so Autumn and I are systems close to each other, like right next to each other. So that's pretty cool. And I also named Jeremy Heal... the planet, another planet in the Autumn system. So there's two planets in the Autumn system, Jeremy and Game Edge. So I also did some work off camera. I got up a little over 1 million credits. I was going to save enough for a really good ship, but I'm looking at like about 1.5 million credits. And I, you know, just got bored of grinding. So I wanted to make a video. So when I was up on the space station, I had a... I had a little, like, distress signal type thing on this planet, and it's right over there. That's where the game wants me to go next, and that is going to take me on the next part of my quest. But when I was farming, I actually found this little facility here. So I'm gonna look around. I was actually selling and stuff to this facility, but I didn't want to talk to anybody or do anything really interesting. So all I did was go in there and sell and buy, and there is a guy in here. Alright, so this looks like a new dude. That's a new dude. All right. At arms. Okay. Well, let's talk. What's up, bro? I don't know anything about you. What is that? What is that? Viking? Viking, maybe? Probably Viking. The warrior's nostrils flare as I approach it. Okay, blah, blah, blah. So it wants stuff. I don't know what it wants. It doesn't say anything about what it wants. Well, let's read this. It inhales deeply and barks out what could be a warning. I hurriedly mime that I am peaceful. Peace, bro. And know little of its kind or language. It takes a second to think and suddenly grabs my multi-tool while barking again into my visor. streaking out saliva. This dude's gross. It's pointing at the indicator that shows which elements I carry. I do my best to keep calm. Okay, so it wants me to give it stuff. So, should I give it isotopes, oxide, or silicate? Well, he's pissed off, and he's very aggressive. I don't know if there's enough clues in here to tell what I should be giving him. I'm going to give him iron, because when I think of aggressive, pissed off things, I don't know, I think of iron. So let's go ahead and get some iron. Can we reach our starship from here? Probably don't have any more iron. We got some iron. All right, cool. All right, let's give him some iron. Yeah, I mean, aggressive, pissed off warrior type, I would think of iron, personally, but... Okay. The warrior grunts. It teaches me some language of his people. Okay. All right, cool. So now I have to give him carbon to keep talking to him. Let's talk to him again. I don't have any carbon. Alright, let's grab some carbon out of our ship. I don't have any carbon in my ship, do I? Really? I got rid of all my carbon? Well, carbon's easy enough to get. Let's go grab some carbon quickly. Come to Papa. There we go. Alright, that'll be enough to talk to him a couple times. And I got a journey milestone. I met 6 aliens. Okay. Very good. Oh, that's not the same guy, is it? Or, wait, is that the same guy, or is he just sitting down? I don't know. Whatever, let's talk to him. We'll know if it's the same guy in a minute. It's not the same guy. All right, whatever, let's interact with him. All right, the Viking. Interloper. That doesn't sound good. Where it looks at me, blah, blah, blah. Hand over my multi-tool. The warrior nods in satisfaction offers me an improved multi-tool. That's not improved. That's actually worse. Well, it's improved because it's got better things on it, but, well, barely. Actually, this is much worse. Oh, I can refuse it? Well, let's compare. Alright, so this is mine. Mine has more slots. Mine has better upgrades. If you look right here, mine is better at whatever this is. Well, actually, it's not. But it is better at mining. I don't know what this is, but it is better at mining. And mine's actually better at at shooting as well. Yeah, this one doesn't even have a bolt caster. No, I don't want your crappy multi-tool. Did I actually take it? No, okay. Well, good. I wasn't sure if I would have to take it or not. Thank God I didn't. Let's go to the other building. I'm trying to figure out where the hell I went originally. Yeah, I must have went in this one. We're going to explore this little area for a while, and then we're going to go to our next quest objective area. Yeah, this is the first guy we were talking to. Alright. So we should be able to request stuff from him now. Interloper! Request healing, request new word. Let's get a new word. Visual. Okay. Very good. I'll get more words from them, but I'm not going to sit here like learning words on camera. That would be kind of, you know, boring. All right. So we got a new multi-tool tech. Wide shot adapter. This basically turns into a shotgun, I think. So that basically turns into a shotgun, right? Ooh, it's +5, whatever that means. Bullcaster shots are granted a wide cone of destruction. Yeah, I don't want a shotgun. I'm not a big fan of shotguns. I like more rifle type things.
Units received.
Whenever they say that, it always sounds like they say Unix. Unix received. I'm like, what? But no, it's units. Alright, so that's it for this area. Alright, let's go check the other buildings. By the way, I learned how to do that like super run sprint thing. So you just sprint and you press Q, and then right after that, jetpack. And it makes you really fast as long as you're in the air. Let's talk to him once. Why not? By the way, when these people want carbon, make sure you have enough carbon, because if you have like 19 carbon and they want 20, you'll give them 19 and then they just won't talk to you. And then you'll have to go get another, you'll have to get another 20 anyway. Oh, I request units. I have to be ally or above. Okay, interesting. Alright. What do we got here? Okay. Don't care about that. That should be increased. First aid. I'm pretty sure I'm full on health. This should be free monies. This is where I was selling. This is a gun. I actually looked through this gun in between videos. This is actually, it looks a lot like the one he wanted to give me. Oh no, this one is a bolt caster. So nah, I want to keep doing more slots. Although maybe slots alone isn't the best way to judge. Maybe not. I don't know.
Temperature levels stabilizing.
Is that everything? Yeah, I got everything in here. Okay. Alright, so that was the big building over there. That's a big building over here. There's a little building. Let's check out the little building, and then let's go to our waypoint. Once I get the ability to make fuel for my ship, for the hyperdrive, then I'm going to definitely start looking for another ship. I just want to make sure I get all of the blueprints I'm supposed to. By the way, the stuff that's on this planet is copper, and there is some, I think aluminum or something like that. I don't remember what it was. I don't remember. There was something else that was on this planet. And if you go in those caves right there, that's a really good place to get plutonium. And there's actually some gold in there as well. Oh, there's even more buildings here than I thought. All right.
Temperature levels stabilizing.
Okay. Oh, what we got here? Long ago, it seems, an automatic distress call went unanswered. If I can crack the encryption pattern. Okay. These are the same ones, right? Why are they giving me the same patterns over and over? I've only seen two patterns so far. It's kind of weird, right? Distress signal detected. What was it? Just, is it? Oh, I haven't even discovered this outpost yet. I gotta discover it. Distress signal. Is that the distress signal? No, that's, oh, a crashed ship. Interesting. Okay. People told me the crashed ships usually aren't that good, so I'm not gonna probably worry about it. I mean, I'll probably go check it out, but I'm not. Plus, somebody said like if the crash ship, even if you repair it, you have to continue repairing stuff from it. So I'm not sure if like that's true or not, but I don't know. I'm probably just gonna buy my own ship, I guess. What the hell is this? Satellite? Okay, nothing over here. Okay, let's grab some plutonium. Okay. It's iron, okay. Where's the save point that allows me to discover this area? Am I just missing it, or... Oh, there it is. Right in the middle. Right by my ship, of course. There we go. I got a lot more waypoints to name people after, and also animals. I'm not gonna name people after, foliage or, like, you know, plants or anything like that, because... You know, I don't think anyone wants to be a plant, so we'll have plenty of stuff to name people after. All right, I don't know. I think I hit every building. Let's just go. I want to be here all freaking day. Excuse me. Okay, so let's go this way. I've seen people boost in, like, go really fast in atmosphere. I don't know how they did it, though. It's not really going to take me an hour to get there, is it? Seriously? Oh, there we go. Alright, we're not quite there yet, but we discovered a little bit of a little thing over here, a little outpost. What is that?
Nice. Hold on.
Let me see what this is. It's probably copper. I'm pretty sure that's copper. Let's just make sure. And yes, the copper I've been mining has been floating. Yeah, that's copper. Copper's okay. I think it's worth about 130 or so per unit. It's nothing like crazy you gotta like go out of your way for, but crash right into my ship. Alright, let's discover this waypoint. Check it out really quick. It looks like a small one, shouldn't take too long. Oh, there's one of those things. Yeah. I should probably unlock some stuff on this planet. I'm gonna go careful with unlocking stuff on planets. Like, I don't want to unlock too much stuff at once. But I think I might want to unlock this one. Let me see what I have. I don't have any iron. I'm gonna need some iron. That's easy enough to get. Let's get some iron from right here. And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna make a bypass chip. And we are going to open up a monolith because it's one of the things I haven't gone to yet, and some people have been asking me to. Did I hit this? Oh, you can hit it multiple times. Okay, yeah, I did hit it. That's what I thought. All right. Let's open up a monolith. I think people said that one of these is a thing that will give you free upgrades to your suit. I think it was the I forget which one they said. One of the outpost ones, maybe, or the shelter, something like that. So I definitely want to upgrade my suit. Okay, so we just got some technology. We got some tech, and let's take a look in here. Get some more tech. Ooh, rapid fire for the bolt caster. Bolt caster rate of fire system upgrade. That's not bad. Read encyclopedia. So I learned the, oh, it's Viking. Viking. Like, almost like Viking, I guess. I don't think it's Viking. I think it's Viking. I don't really know, though. I'm sure you guys will let me know in the comments. Alright, I've learned 10 words. Look at me go. And it looks like everything in here. Okay, let's get going. can't believe how freaking long it took me to get here. It's incredible how long it took me to get here, guys. Like, the numbers kept going up and down, saying I was getting closer. It would take less time to get there and then longer to get there. I was like, what the hell, man? But I'm finally here. So, let's see what we got going on. Alright. Alright, got some plutonium, so that's good. Don't see anything else in the immediate area. Oh, we're gonna have to break in, aren't we? Shoot. Alright, well, let's grab some of these guys.
Units received.
Actually, I keep forgetting to scan stuff. Did I get it? Yes, okay. Alright, guys. Switching to guns. Let's go ahead and save. This is really a good time to save because we're about to have the proverbial feces hit the fan. Alright. Switch to guns. Make sure we're loaded. Let's make sure our guns are powered. Oh, I don't have grenades. You know what? I should probably get plasma launcher.
Technology installed. Technology there we recharge. Go. Warning. Sentinel combat unit deployed.
Yeah, I know. Where is he? Whatever. Oh, there he is. There he goes. Alright, let's come in here and hide. If we come in here and hide, they should leave us alone. Oh, life support, huh? Oh, there we go.
Technology recharge. Technology recharge.
They won't come in here. At least last time I did this, they didn't come in here. Grenade propulsion. Plasma launcher grenades travel at higher velocity. That seems pretty interesting.
Units received.
Oh, we don't need any shield. Alright, what you got? What you got going on, bro? Blah, 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 blah. Take antimatter formula. With this knowledge, I can create warp cells. The final puzzle piece. I can now travel anywhere I please. Excuse me. Yep, and that's what I was looking for. Electron vapor. Craft products in inventory. Okay, we can craft that, huh? Can we craft that yet? We should probably look. Yeah, we can. So we need suspension fluid. So we need carbon. Plutonium. Heridium, zinc. Thamium. So, yeah, kind of like one of everything.
Temperature levels stabilizing.
Alright. The Viking are a little bit happier with me. Alright, is anybody mad at me out here? We cool? We cool, bro? Yeah, we cool. We cool. Nuisance, destroyed 10 sentinels. Did I really? Have I destroyed 10 sentinels? So who's the nuisance, me or them? Because they're always getting up in my business. Alright, well, let's start towards making another warp drive thingy. Alright, so, we're gonna need the carbon. Okay, do we have carbon in here? Probably not. I don't want to mess around with any warp drive stuff around here, because those damn sentinels are gonna be all over my business. Oh, I forgot to loot one. Nah, whatever. Let's just go look for a nice place with maybe some interesting materials. Oh, should we go towards the monolith? Depends on how far it is, man. It took me a long time to get here. I guess we should go to the monolith. Alright. See you at the monolith, guys. Okay, it seems the best way to get to these things on the planets are to literally just come into space and use your, like, warp speed thing. Because, man, I'm telling you right now, dude, like, it would take forever to get there if I stayed on the planet. It was probably literally on the other side of the planet. So it makes sense that it was so far away. So just go, do yourself a favor and go to space and then just like kind of travel along, you know, the top, like stay in space, but travel like towards like right above the waypoint. It's kind of hard to explain. Maybe next time there's a waypoint really far away, I'll take you there the whole time, and that way I can show you exactly what I mean. All right. Let's check this bad boy out. Ooh. Okay, so we got some things to interact with here. We learned the word warp. We learned the word Viking. And ancients. Okay. Now let's walk up to the big old bad monolith. Yep. Come on, Cage, get up there. You could do it. Okay. I place my palm on the monolith, then stand back. When it melts in response to my touch, molten rock drips down the stone, exposing a hollow interior. Inside, I see riches that are beyond belief, ancient technology and cargo that would aid my journey. Lava continues to drop, and the edifice? Probably. Seems unstable. But equipment that could aid me is within arm reach. The voice of an ancient tribe shakes the ground I stand on. We're going to stand back. The ancient warriors who once worshipped here bless my show of respect. Cool. So I did the right thing. Good. Good. Alright, health is at maximum. Standing is increased. I learned the Atlas word for awake. I got a Viking effigy. Okay, 25,000 units. Okay. Yeah, pretty interesting. Okay. Is there any stuff we can hunt? Oh, what's that? That's copper, right? Let's take a look at this. I'm pretty sure that's copper. I'm going to be looking for stuff to make my warp drive. So, yeah, that's copper. I do not need copper. Actually, what do I need to make the warp drive? I need... Oh, yeah, carbon. That's right. Carbon to start. Oops. Get a bunch of carbon. There we go. Alright, so let's make a few of these. Well, let's just make one for now. And then we can make one of these. And then we can make one of these. And then, wow, that was easy. Let's see if we can make more. Not bad. Not bad, people. Yeah, I think it's time we can get a new ship. I'm surprised how much of this I'm able to make. I didn't know I had that much stuff on me. Alright, starship, hyperdrive. Technology recharge. Almost fully charged. I think one of those is good for one jump. Let's make some more. Oh, we're missing plutonium. Alright, that shouldn't be so hard to get. Although, I'm not seeing any. You get plutonium from caves. Yeah, that looks pretty interesting over there. Oh, here we go. Knowledge stone. Oh, good word for warrior. Alright, it seems that I'm freezing to death. We might want to actually get off this planet. It is not really... There's not great stuff on it, to be honest. And it's always really cold. So... I think we should probably go somewhere else. We're about to freeze to death, too. Alright, guys. I think I'm going to go check out another planet next episode. We're going to call this one here. That's going to be it for... That is going to be it for episode 7. We'll see you next time for episode 8. Till then, take it easy.